What's up, guys? Jordan from Bennett's Customs here, back on the race car as per usual. On this week episode, I'm making a hood. I'm kind of jumping a few steps ahead, but essentially just want to make the hood to see the whole body lines of how everything's going to follow. I'm going to take it off the stands, we're going to roll it outside, and just have a look at it against a plain back wall and just see the proportions. I'm going to sit in it, make sure everything looks all right. We'll bring it back in here, stick it back up on the stands, and then it'll basically stay on these until final assembly. Cut out the cardboard. I'm gonna make a hood for it now. And then we're just gonna make sure that all the proportions are correct. We're gonna cut it out of some aluminum, and we are going to get this off and outside and just see what it looks like and make sure it doesn't look like a bathtub or a shoehorn or something kind of weird. There's something about it I don't like, but I think once I get it outside and I'm sitting in it and I take a few photos, it might look different. Make sure you guys like and subscribe and hit that notification button, and let's get into it. Basically, we have a sheet of 1.6 aluminum with a nice sticker on it, and it is brushed, so I may even keep it like that. Not really sure what I'm gonna do. Template, rough template. I've now marked it out on some steel or aluminum, sorry. And we've got it basically laid out. I've allowed quite a big of an edge around so I can trim it down to fit. And then this 25 mil, I'll be able to actually break after we've got the contour. So we're gonna grab the English wheel. We're gonna throw the rubber top onto it so we get a two-dimensional shape, and we'll match the contour and actually try and do a few test panels to see if we can get this to match. Right, so basically we're gonna see which one's gonna line up best. I think it's nearly about a six. So I've matched that with one of my lower anvils, and that just a little bit more than a six, but it's kind of between a six and a four, so I think this will do. But you know, we'll just try obviously on a test panel and see what's going to happen. So let's fit this. All right, so we got our rubber tube on there, or whatever you want to call it. And then we do have our nice little die that matches the radius that we're trying to achieve. So what I'm gonna do is actually run one pass straight down here, and that's just gonna kind of give me a bit of a peak, because there is a slight peak here and on the cowl.
once I have that, I'll be able to lay it down, and then I can start to figure out exactly where the bend starts, and then I can start making some lines, and then, yeah, basically just a, you know, not a whole lot of pressure, and I'm just gonna go really slow, take my time, and honestly, I'm not really that upset if I screw up this panel. I just want to try it. You know, it's something fun to do anyways. I'm just sick of cutting and welding, so I want to get this on, and I want to get it off and get it outside, so let's see what we can come up with. Even use like a little bit of metho on here and on the surface just to kind of get it tacky, let it sit. I tried a heat gun spinning it and had the heat gun on it to see if it would shrink a little bit on there. It just did not work. So I use tape. I've seen quite a few people use it. It seems to be working so far. I have rolled out both sides and basically it has worked. It's still two-dimensional. It's not stretching it in any way three-dimensional. So I'll just show you. I'll just take it over here, plop it on. I'm very close. And yes, there is like a few marks in here from the wheel, especially like these two. I think that's just purely not having that bottom thing adjusted, and on mine it's actually off center. What I mean by that is this here is not actually square, it's kind of off, and that could also be the reason why it was spitting that top rubber wheel off. So I've got it on there and it's starting to take some shape, and if I press down there you can see it is very close. So I just need to do a little bit more through here just to pull that side in, but it's actually starting to look pretty neat. So I want to, yeah, just keep doing a few more passes trying to get it to fit properly, but I'm definitely liking the way this is coming out. So too bad. I think this one will be maybe just a test panel. You can't really see it, but there's a few lines in here from the wheel, and I just don't know if I really like it. So I may try and do another one and see if I can just smooth them out. They're really good, like where there's multiple passes, that it obviously kind of has like smoothed itself out from doing all the passes, but there's just like, it's really hard to see in this light, but there's just a few, there's one right there you can kind of see. And that was just trying to get a little bit of that contour there, but basically it is doing the job. It's giving me a profile. It's starting to look, you know, really cool. This is kind of a neat angle, actually. I saw, kind of gives you a better idea what it looks like. And then when we got the headers coming out, it should, you know, really look quite cool. So I'm digging it. It's time to get this side finished today so that we can do the back bit. So small goals, but I would love to get this side welded in. I'd love to get that top piece done and start working on the back. And I want to take this off the lift, as I've mentioned several times, just to have a look at it. So
I think what the biggest thing is that usually like these early kind of late 30s, early 40s, you know, kind of Indy style or Miller style single race cars, the cowl is set back a lot further, and then there's a huge dip in the back of the quarter panel, and that's for your elbows and, you know, steering room, and so you can kind of lean, which is totally cool, and I actually still really like that look. But I was just trying to do something a little bit different, and I think when you look at the back of it, it looks really neat, and then when you kind of come this way, it just looks a little bit weird. But what I think it's missing is a huge ingredient, and that is the pipes. I think once the pipes go on, I'm just going to try and hold up a little bit of a template, so they're going to come kind of swoop up and then all the way out the back, something kind of like that. And then once there's three, you know, inch and a half pipes that are traveling all the way out the back, it's just really gonna fill that void that I see. Like, I know simple is better, but it just looks like something's missing. I don't know if it's because the cowl is so tall, or maybe it's a little bit too long. Maybe I'm just not proportioned for these little things, which, I mean, I'm not maybe, I certainly am. So, but I think it looks cool. And what I'm gonna do, as I explained before, these are the cutoffs from the Model A, and I really wanna stick them in here. I think they would just really work. They got a nice taper to them, and they would just kinda suit. So right now, I'm gonna trim and cut and mock one of these in, tack it into place, and see what it looks like. So, there we have the nice Model A tapered rear frame rail clamped into place. I'm just gonna tack this and then we'll slide the body over and just see what it looks like. But I have a feeling it's gonna look really nice. Just kind of finishes it off. So let's tack this into place.
very nice weld.
Lots of penetration.
So that should look relatively nice going in there.
All right, one's welded in. Kind of hard to see with the lighting, but man, it just really finishes off the back part of this. I don't know if you can kind of see it, but yeah, just really makes a huge difference. I think it kind of just like maybe elongates the frame and doesn't make the back of the body look so long, but I'm really digging it, you know, considering that was kind of the other side. It just, I mean, I never finished those because I never knew what I was going to do with them, but I'm happy with it. I think it looks really cool. And I'll just leave them like that. And then whether or not I, you know, make some little push bars that come off of it, I think what I'll do is just do a single one like that. And I'll make like a nice little stainless bend, like it'll kind of come up and around and bolt into here. And then have that on the end, like a nice little bumperette sort of thing, push bar type thingamajigger, you know? So let's measure the other one and we'll cut the other one on and get it installed with the camera that's got a fresh battery, because you probably never got to see me finish that, so that's cool. Outside in a few hours, but I want to get this little back bit of the panel kind of buttoned up slightly, or even just kind of like clecoed into place, just so we can see what it looks like. I've run out of my usual template paper, so what I have is just a couple pieces of paper taped together. This is going to give us a template, then I can transfer it onto the steel in order to get our pattern, and we can start shaping it. So all we're going to do, we're just going to tape this into place. We're going to add where our little shrinks are and, you know, accurately try and get a pretty good template off this. And then we will start to shape it. So I'm going to do the old dirty finger technique that many of you have seen. And we're going to get this kind of hopefully, you know, relatively dialed in and put it onto some steel. It's outside. It's over our little puddle we always take photos of, you know? Kind of gives you an underside shot as well. It's pretty cool. But damn, this thing is cool.
It looks so good outside. It's
yeah, it's kind of nice not to see it in such a constrictive area. And you know, kind of gives you a bit more of a gauge on the way it is and what it looks like, but
pretty happy with it.
Didn't show anywhere, didn't show how I did it, because I literally thought I was going to scrap this piece because I wasn't very happy with it at the very beginning. I was mainly doing it as a test panel to see if I could get the contour that I wanted before tipping it and everything, and then I just kept going with it and then realized it was going to work. So that was cool. So I was kind of already planning on making two of these, because I wanted to do two different ones to see which one I liked better. And then this one just kind of took the form that I wanted it to. So I will show you the shaping of this rear portion. So basically, I tried to replicate the same as the front grill with kind of the blister that we've made, or body line, or whatever you want to call it, and it kind of comes and then fades out, so there's still a line from the tip, but you can't actually feel it. So once that's primed and painted, you'll just kind of have this really neat line that'll kind of just fade. And so I wanted to try and bring that into the back portion somehow, and so I've done the exact same. Is I've brought it right down and then it fades and then there's nothing there, so that's actually just going to fall and that'll go right into this curved piece that we have to make. So, and then I just tried to obviously cut it so it kind of came straight up and down, and then basically this is going to get steeled out all the way around the edge. I'm unsure what I'm going to use still. I may use some square tubing or just some round like 10 mil stock or something, just to put something around the edge. But I'm really happy with the way it looks. It really kind of like follows what I was trying to like achieve. So I think it looks really, really cool. But we have to fill this huge void right here. So that's on today's agenda, trying to get this sorted. So basically what I'm gonna do is just kind of free ball it. I'm not gonna make a wire buck for it at all. And fingers crossed I can kind of come up with something. It's not the most complex shape, but it is a bit tricky. You know, you're kind of going from a bit shallower of a contour, and then by the bottom it gets quite sharp. And then as well as the fall of this is, you know, very gradual, and then at the bottom it really tucks in. So there is a bit of shrinking and, you know, a couple different, probably use a couple different dies in the English wheel to try and get this to fit properly. But let's give it a red hot crack, see what I can come up with, see if it'll make any sense. But what I'm gonna do is just trim up a couple pieces of steel, do some measurements. I'm gonna allow, you know, quite a bit on each end just to be able to trim it where well we can get it, and let's see if we can close this up, start to make it look like a proper boat tail or something similar. I don't really actually like boat tails, to be honest, but that's why I kind of kept this one short and stumpy. I don't really like those big long gradual wing looking things. And then another thing I need to try and figure out, I'm not sure if you can quite see this in the camera, the line of this is very nice. Like it fault, like the whole quarter panel all the way to the front grill is like just fits, like it's so nice. This side, not so much. Comes off, has this huge bubble, and then it's stretched right here, because I thought it would be a good idea when I was originally trying to straighten these rear fenders out, I thought it'd be a good idea to put this part in the English wheel with the lowest crown die. And I basically was just trying to straighten it out. I was just seeing if like I could straighten it out, but
what I did was essentially stretch it. So now I've kind of got this like bow that I need to work with. So I need to try and like either shrink it a little bit and then bring it back in. I do know that once, like there is a bit of play in it. So I know once I add that structure all the way around, that's gonna help heaps. So what I'm gonna try and do is, yeah, like I said, we're gonna make this rear portion. Once that's done, I'm gonna remake again. I'm gonna remake these. And I'm gonna try and obviously make it, kick it up around and then end it kind of right at the end of there, at the end of the frame rail. But what I'm gonna do is just do like maybe every 75 mil or every 50 mil or something like that, not every 30 mil like this. I think it may just be too many and it kind of might look goofy. That's just probably another thing, another step back, you know, with this bloody time on here. But I just, you know, I want to do it right the first time. So it didn't take me very long to make these. I'll just break them. I'll hang these ones up. There'll be a use for them somewhere. And then I'll probably try and maybe bring in a couple of rivets into here maybe. I don't know. We'll see. Let's get this rear panel sorted. Here's my panel. I did make it a little bit wider on either side just so I have a bit of room to play. And yeah, obviously several ways I could do this. Could just use the wheel and the rubber band and the planishing hammer and or heaps of different tips. I was literally just speaking to Carl about it. I think what I'm gonna do is do exactly what I did with this, and that was just using the bag and this gorgeous thing that I absolutely love, the Mother Tucker. Thank you, Carl. Brought this home in my surfboard bag. I wonder if customs questioned what it was, but pretty self-explanatory. They obviously knew. Maybe the security guard, you know, watches the channel and knew what I was up to. But we're gonna use this, we're gonna bash that, and then we're gonna roll it in the wheel, and then we're gonna hold it up there and see if we're anywhere near where we're trying to be. So let's get started. Right, that was just with
few passes. Obviously, the wheel that I have matches the same crown. I use the contour gauge and it kind of follows that portion. So you can see just after a bit of hammer and wheeling, like that thing's pretty spot on nearly already. It needs a ton of shrinking kind of towards the bottom, but I'm just gonna see if I can get this relatively close and then we'll start to work down to the bottom. So it, yeah, damn, looks freaking cool. Just added a few lines and that's just gonna give me like two indications of where I can come in on my first pass on the shrinker and then my second one. I don't think I have this set up quite right. Like it kind of does a lot of damage to the metal. I know shrinkers are supposed to shrink the metal, but I feel like I need to play around with it and adjust it, but it, yeah, it certainly does the trick of what I need it to do, so that's a good thing. And nothing's bolted down in here. Really wish it was. I'd definitely get a lot more kick out of this thing if, you know, if it was bolted down, but it's because we're gonna do some renovations in the workshop and try and create a bit more space and have a bit more of the metal fab area kind of, so I suppose, like separate to everything. And there is plans of getting the plasma table, which would be extremely exciting. We'll do a shop tour once everything's kind of set up and I'll kind of show you around and the plans that we have. Did there was I only shrunk just half of this on the outside where I was going to really pull it in because I thought it was tucking more here, but what I've noticed is it actually fits like really nice and then it starts to pull in. So essentially I do need to just pull those edges a fair bit more, but it's starting to look like something. Thank you. So I'm just running.
I don't know if you can see that. There's some areas like where I wanted it to be a four. So it's kind of stretched in the center, what I try to do with the hammer, and then it's just a little bit inconsistent. Actually, that's supposed to be a six, which is very close. And then we want it to tighten up kind of to a four in here. So I'm just gonna run a planishing hammer just over a few of these bits and just see if we can kind of smooth it out just a little bit. So basically, yeah, try and get this just to fit a little bit better. So that's about a six. And then we'll go to a four about there. So that's four. This is a six. Shallower there, and then this should be, yeah, that's four. That should be tightened. Could go, yeah. See what the bottom does. I'm not too worried about it because I think that gets all cut off. But basically, this area I just want to shape just a little bit more. Using the planishing hammer, I was able to really get this like super nicely finished. Well, the center, not the edges too much. I'm not too worried about them. They fit really nice, but I just needed to stretch kind of this area in here. So now you can see, is that the front? Towards the front. We got a really nice, relatively consistent, well, I only needed it basically a six from here up, so that's perfect. And then throughout the back, we needed about a four till about there, and then that's kind of when the panel ends. So this is awesome. This has really worked out. I just went and put it up against the panel and it fits so good. So I'm gonna show you. Okay, here's our panel. Basically butts up really nice to that. And if you can see when that is in there and kind of held into place, I'll get some Clecos in it and then you can see better, but the transition is like perfect. So I think that'll do really, really well. Maybe I'll even leave the tail on the bottom. But let's try and get this fitted in place. Butt is on and it looks really, really good. I'm just gonna raise this bit up just a little bit just to get this to fit really nice. I had it fitting really good before and then I kind of screwed it down a little bit too tight. So I think even if I were to kind of like just pinch it so slightly, get a tack on it, like it'd be good. But yeah, the fitment of it all the way down is really, really nice. And if you kind of, if I go on this side, maybe you'll see it better. But the actual contour of it is awesome. I'm super, super happy with the way it turned out. Like basically when this is fully, you know, even to it, it's just got this really nice fall. Starts to like, it's a little bit straight here is what I've kind of wanted. And then it just falls right into that. So essentially once it's all tacked into place, you know, it should just have a really nice profile. These will kind of stop and then the rest of this will just kind of fall in. You know, this has kind of got that radius of that six and a bit of the four, which is what I tried to kind of bring into this. And then the fall where this pulls in, everything should be kind of lined up. You know, I used like a wire buck in a few areas just as a gauge and it worked out really nice. So I think next step is to just try and get this fitted. I'm gonna scribe this area, pull the panel off, and then I will end up, you know, I'll just do a little bit of work with the hammer and dolly just in these areas, but I just wanna clean all this area up on both sides. And then I think, like, you know, I probably should leave these in two panels and like split the cowl again, and then I have like two panels to work with that I can hammer and dolly all the welds. But to be very honest, the planishing hammer and the hammer and dolly, that stuff's all portable. So if I need to, I'll just sit here with the slapper and go along it and, you know, kind of get up the high and low spots. But I think what I want to do is just structurally get this area tight and so nothing's going to move. And then I can kind of work on where I want the layout of the lower part of the body where it's going to meet the frame. So yeah, I'm going to scribe this, get it off, clean it up, and then we'll continue going forward. Of the final piece of the puzzle. As you can see, like that's the top and then the bottom kicks in a lot. Like I really had to shrink this area to gradually go, and then it pulls in quite a bit at the bottom. So if you see it like this, it's basically a big shoehorn. Just slide my butt straight on in. Might have to just do that. Go like that and fucking straight into it. So the reason why I tucked in the bottom so much is because I wanted to kind of follow those body lines in that contour there. And then what I'll end up doing is probably adding some corner pieces on both sides just to bring it down a little bit more. I think it looks really good, kind of a bit lower. So we're gonna get this mocked up, scribed, tacked into place, and then we'll see kind of what we need to do. When your love's gone, Is tacked into place and was pretty easy actually. Yeah, you can kind of see with the light coming through, it's a real nice tight fit. There was a few like dents in the fender that I just kind of had to planish out just before welding, but yeah, I think it's all right. There's a tiny bit of a gap right here, but I think once I start welding it, it'll pull in, and you know, I can kind of stretch that out afterwards with the planish, like when I planish this area. But yeah, I think like ultimately I'm really happy with the way that's turned out. It's just really brought those together and has really completely changed like the whole profile. And then this kind of comes down, and then I'll probably join these pieces here and just do something in there. But what we're going to try and do is now fit the top. Usually I would like to tack all the pieces in at once, but I wanted to get the main piece of this kind of fitted so that the quarters are, you know, both kind of where they should be. Even if you can kind of see like down, like it's like the profile is almost virtually the same. I think this has just got a little bit of a rise right here. But once I planish it, it'll be good. So what we're gonna do is try and get that now fitted into here, tack that into place, and then if I'm feeling ambitious, I may just weld the whole lot and see what we can come up with. ¶¶
Chattanooga boy had a dollar and a dime. Hit it out for Nashville on the Hard Rock Line. I'm working on that old steamboat and learned to ride and steam. When my feet had touched dry land, how happy I did feel. Been saving every penny for to make up through the fall. Working for that dollar, but it never adds up at all. Coming around the riverbank, heard the old train was so sane. The very next thing you hear from me, I've been tied to a ball and chain. Well, come this time tomorrow, reckon I don't know where I'll be. But if it wasn't for that old sheriff, I'd be back in Tennessee. Playing cards and crap games, not looking for the score. And if I ever get back home again, I'll never own no more. Good time, boys, listen to my song. May not know better, but I know you know right from wrong. Buy yourself a postcard so you can see the lights of town. Find yourself a country girl, keep quiet and settled.
Stoked.
Not gonna lie, I'm really happy with the way it's come out. I just had one
So my only issue, I do have one, and I'm gonna fix it,
is that when I tipped this side, and then I had to fade it out. So when I was tipping it, I had pressure on it to obviously lift it, and then when I got to here, I had no pressure, and then had to try and add more pressure on this side. So what's actually happened is I haven't tipped it enough on this side. So this side's just a little bit higher and this side's a little bit more like extreme as far as like the bend goes. So I just want to fix both sides and then yeah, hopefully it'll, you know, kind of look the part. But basically, as you just saw, I just did one pass on here and then just had like the slapper, and I don't really have a dolly actually that's like totally round on one side that actually gets this. So I just kind of picked it, got all the, you know, low spots up, and then I actually used the planishing hammer with a number six die in it because I have that number six radius, and it's like, yeah, it's done an amazing job. I probably could just do a little bit more work there. There's a tiny little spot where I had to stop and start. I actually slipped off the pedal. So well, basically what I'm gonna do now is just gonna run full passes on the whole lot, and then we're gonna clean it up. I'm gonna hammer and dolly it, gonna planish it, sand it, and fingers crossed we don't get a crazy amount of distortion. It is pretty, you know, compound, like there's quite a bit of curve to it. So I definitely know that these are gonna suck in, but I should be able to kind of work those back out. And yeah, I just wanna see what it's gonna look like, you know, virtually, hopefully seamless. So let's get into doing some welding. Full pass, I'm just using MIG wire 030, I believe, maybe 032. And I've just pulled it straight out of the spool and I've just cut little bits. I've ran out of my wire. So I think it is 032, 030. Anyways, it works. It's doing the job. So I'm gonna do full passes from start all the way there and then all the way down, back up and across. And then we're gonna just take all the tops of the welds off on the inside as well, just so there's no actual weld protruding higher than the actual material, and then we will start to hammer and dolly. Burn through. It's like one little hole there. There's a couple, but you know, consistently the heat is okay. This was a bit of a troubled area because I did have to actually cut it and kind of re-weld it. It was just too tight, even when I was hammering and dolling the tacks along. But that's okay. Got a nice pass on that one there. That was that, you know, the piece I got a bit excited about cutting out. But it'll, yeah. I think it'll be okay. I was able to fuse a little bit of it, and then, you know, there's lots of filler in there still. So now I'm just gonna knock the weld off. We're gonna hammer and dolly a fair bit of it, and then we'll see if we can get the planishing hammer in there and finish it off. Thank you.
lot's done. The hood is finished. Like I mentioned, it might not be the hood that actually stays on this, just because I was having a few dramas with the English wheel at the time, and it's just left a few marks in there, but we'll see. It may stay. Unfortunately, the intake and stuff is not here at the moment, so there's a bit of a void here, but you know, we'll have something that'll sit there. I'll probably end up making like a little blister, kind of reverse cowl type deal that'll come off this so that the air can kind of come in this way, and then obviously try and filter it as best as possible because the dust there is pretty hectic. But yeah, it's on the ground, just getting an over, you know, basically a profile of how everything's gonna work into the back. Obviously super happy with it. I've only kind of roughly finished one side. This side still has been welded, but not obviously, you know, finished, sanded, planished and everything, but it was cool. It was actually fun. I don't have my bullseye pick. I have no idea where it went, but you know, to try and just knock out a few of these low spots would have been really nice. You know, I was able to get in there with a pick and get a few of them out, but I'm also, you know, it is a race car, and with a small amount of body filler through here, primer and paint, and it's going to be in everything. So I think it'll turn out really, really well. We'll see you guys on the next episode. Make sure you like and subscribe, hit notifications. I really appreciate all the comments so far. We've had crazy amount of feedback about this car, and it has been super fun. The deadline is fast approaching, but we are getting it done, as you can see. So we'll see you on the next one.